with Cooper and Simpson out of the side. They're also without Leighton, Angus, McDougall and Weir. So Joe Miller and John Hewitt will support Eric Black in attack. And Brian Mitchell is wearing number 8, but we'll have to see if he plays in that position. I think he'll play right back with McKimmy in midfield. White winning that battle of the youngsters against Joe Miller. Player playing it wide, Barnes with his left thigh heavily strapped. Very important player, of course, for Celtic. Takes it back from McLeod. Stay back with Aiken. Celtic happy, of course, to welcome back Mo Johnston in attack. But they too have opted for strength in midfield with Peter Grant. There he is. He's coming to the side. His strength being preferred to the more delicate skills of Owen Archdeacon, who's been relegated to the bench. Celtic obviously anxious to avenge that 4-1 defeat in the last league match between the clubs at Portadry. And stakes really could not be higher. There's McLeod going through and a little too much pace in the ball, gets it away for the Aberdeen goal. McLeod, here's Grant. McStay. Trying 1-2 with Johnston, the Aberdeen defence stands firm. Now John Hewitt. Beautiful tackle that from Danny McGrain, splendidly timed. Well, this turns the clock back a bit. McGrain going forward in attack. McLeod setting it up for McStay. That came off Mitchell. Stark and Mitchell closing in very quickly to support Miller and McLeish in the heart of the Aberdeen defence on that occasion. There's Stark. Piece of play from Black, jump from Bett. Applause around for Tawdry as Tommy McQueen finds space to move forward. He's away from McGrain. Long deep cross. Helped on by White. Stark chooses to let the ball run for the throw. And a fine piece of fullback play that from Tommy McQueen on the left for Aberdeen. Warner almost came underneath that cross from Mitchell, but with no Aberdeen forward in attendance, he had no problems. Here's Roy Aiken. Miller's header, and McQueen again. That's for Bett. Aiken, McLeod. Good play from Celtic in midfield. Aiken to McStay. The interception was from Stark. Mitchell too far ahead of Eric Black. Well, there was a lack of understanding there at the back. Celtic, O'Leary and Bonner having a debate now. Paul McStay. Cleared as well to find Johnston on the right. McClure is onside. Great chance now for Celtic. Tommy Barnes, blocked by Mitchell, and protests all around from the Aberdeen players about an offside decision which wasn't given by the far side linesman. So Brian McClure breaking after playing initial pass wide, sprinting through, and I think the replay shows the linesman was right. Still a great chance though for Celtic. Tommy Barnes finding a shot, blocked by Mitchell. To retain possession. Now McQueen. Nice start arriving late in the box, but Eric White kept his eye on the ball. And now Barnes. Good play by Barnes, made space for White to move into. Grant appearing at the far side of the box, back towards Johnston. Once again, McLeish is the master in the Aberdeen box. Great. No offside. offside flag again as Johnston and McLear appear to be free. And there's no question that the Aberdeen defence are taking chances. They're standing square and static and hoping for offside decisions. And with these quick Celtic forwards, Johnston and McLear, that could be hazardous as it was on that occasion. Pushed by White on Hewitt at the edge of the box. So a great opportunity once again for Aberdeen. Five-man wall this time with McLeod just off it. Hewitt and Bett over the ball. And again the target. It's gone for a corner kick. And the referee being badgered again by the Aberdeen players for a handball decision. Miller clearly thought that was handled, but if it was, surely the ball played the man. Betts cross, headed away by McStay. Rather unorthodox but effective fashion. And McGrain will be in trouble. Going in late on Joe Miller. So the Celtic captain this time, after some hectic action and the referee Crombie being involved a great deal. Danny McGrain, I think, protesting that's his first foul of the match. It certainly was a severe one in Joe Miller as the youngster cut inside. So the match undoubtedly has reached the stage where Mr. Crombie's refereeing will be very important indeed. Great shot. There's McLeish. And a marvellous save in the end from Pat Bonner. The Celtic players unhappy about the late challenge from Eric Black. But that was great goalkeeping indeed. As the ball was swept inside, it fell kindly at the second attempt to Alec McLeish. He appeared to have found a gap beyond Pat Bonner, but the save was excellent and Eric Black was just a fraction late in getting onto the rebound. Well, next day, now Barnes. Great control from McStay. There's McLeod. Well, some excellent play from the Celtic midfield players. Paul McStay in particular to engineer that shooting chance for Modern McLeod. And it certainly wasn't far away. O'Leary making to the dressing room. And the substitute coming on is Owen Archdeacon. This is Bins. There's Joe Miller. Far side, Hewitt. Good running from Bett. The early ball for Black. Well, that's the sort of chance Eric Black normally snaps up. A magnificent Aberdeen attack. Apologies from Black. The lookout was created. Mainly the run from Bett. Now that takes us back to the Jim Bedivol, right back to his best with that surging run on the left. The first time cross, Black had lost his marker but miscued the header. Bett and McStay together once again. They've not been so often in the match. Danny McGrain. Runs can't reach it. Miller takes up the right position for Aberdeen at the back. Leash for Miller. White beats him to it. McGrain to Barnes. Good play from Willie Miller. Joe Miller nipping in front of McGrain. Celtic throw. The referee now checking his watch and blows for half time. The Celtic get the second hour underway and both sides appreciating, no doubt, at half time that if the scoreline stayed the same, it would not be satisfactory for Premier Division final purposes. Both sides really need to win, and I fancy the second half may take on the context of a cup tie before the end. Aberdeen winning a free kick right at the start of the second half, front of the Celtic dugout. There's Willie Gardner in the Aberdeen dugout behind Brian Mitchell. So no changes in the lineups at half time. Celtic still with their replacement Mark McGee available to come on if necessary. They've already committed Owen Archdeacon, of course, to replace the injured Piers O'Leary. Aberdeen still with John McMaster and Willie Faulkner in reserve. Joe Miller. Willie Miller playing it forward. Turned away calmly by Derek White. There's Black. Mitchell's cross, there's Stark. Willie Stark once again found space in the Celtic box. It was an excellent cross from Brian Mitchell, swinging out, Stark coming in to attack it, got above Peter Grant, but the header went over the bar. Johnston screening it well. McClure getting through the challenge from Tom McQueen. Johnston's first time shot. Well, he's one of the best in the country at that situation, Mo Johnston. It was McClure's strength on the right which set up the chance, getting through the challenge from Tom McQueen, putting the ball across, the first time shot and a good save from Gunn. And the ball squirming away from Joe Miller there, and it's gone for the corner kick. But Joe Miller's attacking power on the left, opening up the Celtic defence. Agonisingly wide of that far post. So the action swinging from end to end, it's John Hewitt with the corner kick. Well held by Bonner. In space on the Celtic right. The angled ball, and there was Mitchell. With Johnston and Archdeacon on each side of him. Turning the ball away for the throw. Well, much of that first half was spent in midfield. The second half starting in goal by Thaction. And there's the opener, Mo Johnston! Johnston at his best. Saluting the Celtic supporters at the beach end. Now this was a goal of the highest quality from a top-class striker. Taking the ball with on the left, turning, easing his way inside, screening the ball from defenders, and rifling the shot beyond Brian Gunn. Kimmy to bet. Playing the ball straight at the legs of Tommy Barnes. Ball McStay made a good run into position outside the box. That'll be a corner kick to Celtic. Well, McStay's runs from midfield really are important for Celtic. Takes up some great positions going forward. Archdeacon's corner, right swinger. Ryan McClure! Well, that was a superb header. Bulleted down, but straight at Brian Gunn. Miller to McQueen. Looking for in space ahead, and up many though because the marking is tight. Up goes McGrain with Black. McClure. Joe Miller wins it from Archdeacon. Good deep cross for Faulkner. Up goes Black. Turned away by Grant. Well, Willie Faulkner adding a new dimension to the Aberdeen attack. Joe Miller doing the good work initially on the right with a fine cross. Up goes Faulkner, number 14, the header down. Black going up with Bonner, got his head to the ball but without enough power to find the net. Out by Johnston. Queen's the man in a hurry for Aberdeen this time. Faulkner beaten by Grant. Stay in the space for Johnston. First time cross, McClure is up. Ball had gone behind, I think, before the cross came in from Johnston. Ryan McClure clearly disagrees. But the linesman was flagging for a goal kick. Johnston sprinted to reach the pass from Paul McStay. Good header from Black, quick Hirschstock. Mitchell. Miller to Betts. Good move from Aberdeen. Barnes gets it away with a good tackle. Can Aberdeen conjure up some goal scoring power in the last 15 minutes of the match? Flags cross, ball is in trouble. Got a vital touch on though to allow McStay to clear it. Between now to McKimmy. And Bett is leaning back as he fed to the ball, playing it over the top. So a goal kick to Celtic. Aberdeen though will perhaps acquire the gamble a little further to change the path of the play. Over the cloud. Now Barnes. The interception was by Miller. Stark. Miller coming to inspire his creative colleagues. Peter Grant wins it from him. Stays pass. Play again in midfield from Celtic. Here's Brian McClure. And now Bett. Miller. Bett took his eye off it. So here's a chance now for Celtic. Johnston in the clear with McClure inside. Johnston's made it! No, the goal is being chopped off. It won't count. Well, it was an error by Jim Bett initially on the halfway line for Aberdeen, which set up the chance. Ball played into the path of Johnston, running in with McClure on the inside. Willie Miller, the only defender. Johnston eventually got the second bite at it and rifled the ball home, but McClure was offside. It's dark. No peace at all from Paul McStay. He's got the free kick away to McKimmy. Now Miller. Willie Miller. Joe Miller running well on the left. McMaster. Great ball from John McMaster. No takers though for Aberdeen. Well, perhaps the Aberdeen supporters thinking of what might